Welcome to Women on the Move Live. This show is all about women who are in business, women are doing business, and women that are just fabulous and amazing. How about that? Well, look, I need you to call a friend, tweet a friend, hit them up on Instagram. You know, you can do that little Snapchat thing too, and let them know Women on the Move Live is on the air. Well, my guest today is one of the top radio personalities in the city of Atlanta. I want you to welcome Miss Sasha the DIVA.
Hey!
How you doing,
girl? I love love.
Oh, yes.
And let me give love back to you. Thank you for having me here. Thank you for listening to Kiss. I really appreciate it. Because we got to give more sister love.
Oh, we do. We do. And you look fabulous.
Girl, it wasn't on me, okay?
You look good.
So
wow. I love
you.
It. I love
gotta it. Got to take care of yourself, honey.
Every day.
Eat good.
All day.
I don't exercise.
Oh.
Great family. Great relationship. Pray. I'm good. I'm in a good space.
That is good. And I mean, it's good for, you know, everyone to see you. Because we hear you, and we don't always get a chance to see you unless we're at one of the promos. But it's great to have you here
today.
Yes,
girl. You know I be in the streets now.
Yes, you do.
I do a little bit of everything.
And everywhere, and that's good.
Yeah.
I mean, you're doing the north side, the south side. It's, I mean, you're all around.
Everywhere, Kim.
Yes.
And you have to go everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's just clubs and community service. Look, I say community service. I'm in the club. I do the church. We got to do everything.
Right, but it's all community.
It is.
It's all and good, positive love from you.
I haven't seen you come out and party with me. Yeah.
No, I need to get out, huh? You know,
yes.
I kind of stopped going out to party, but I'm gonna have to just say, oh, you know, Sasha's gonna be there. I'm gonna go
just,
check
just
it out.
Just come having some coffee and some conversation.
Yes,
okay.
I love it like today. Well, look, you are a native of New York City.
Yeah, and you're New Jersey.
Yes, I'm a brick from the Brick City, Newark, New Jersey.
Okay, I'm Brooklyn.
Oh, wow.
White Plains, a little bit of everything.
Oh, I used to go to White Plains to go to the movies and all that good stuff.
Girl, every time I go to New York, I have to have a bite of a corned beef sandwich, hot dog, pizza.
Mm-hmm.
I have to miss it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The last time I was home a couple of months back, earlier this year, and I had to go. I went to Manhattan. First thing I did was, well, I didn't do the hot dog.
Okay.
I was like, no, I'm going to keep going. But I had to have my pizza.
Yes.
I had to have pizza. I even went by White Castle.
How many sandwiches did you eat?
No, I just got three cheese.
Okay.
I said, let me just keep it low because I had a pizza, so let me keep it down.
It is so hard.
But I just love to walk the streets and smell.
Yes, and the lights and the action. And it's like New York, just it doesn't sleep.
No, it never
just
does.
People.
And it's, at night it's even bright, so people don't realize that.
I love the people. I just like to look and just,
people
they're
watch.
Just free. They're just free. I love New York, but I love Atlanta too.
Yes. Oh, yeah, this is our home now.
Yeah.
So how long have you been in the radio industry?
Girl, now you know I'm 20. Okay,
yes,
anyway.
Okay. That's right.
I mean, I've been doing it since I was 17.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah,
oh,
when
my
I was little, Kim,
girl, this
don't.
Is knowledge over here, though. I mean, my goodness.
Yeah. Well, what happened when I was real little,
mm-hmm.
I used to go in the bathroom and get up onto Tortoise and look in the mirror with utensils and mimic Barbara Walters.
Get out. And oh, wow, that's awesome.
Because that's what I saw.
Uh-huh,
because it was none of us.
That's
okay?
right, it was.
And
yes.
my dad used to call me Little Diva. So that's why I call myself Sasha the Diva.
Look at that.
Because of my
girl.
Father. This is what I wanted to do.
Wow.
So through high school and going to college, nothing else but radio. And I have humble beginnings. You look, people be looking at you thinking, you know, oh my God, her life is so fabulous. They go here, they do this, this lifestyle. Child,
that's a lot
look,
of work. They don't
I had to intern.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't make no money. And for these interns that want to get paid, child, please.
Yeah. Oh,
look.
That's a whole nother
conversation.
Look, off camera.
They don't need to get paid, okay?
Look,
when they said, Sasha, I need a cup of coffee, I would say, how many cream, how many sugar, and what else do you need?
Humble.
Yes. And through that, I learned the game.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
Crack.
I got it, girl.
Yes.
And then my first job, I was making $6 an hour.
Yes.
$6,000 an hour in an efficiency apartment with no furniture, and eating tuna fish and Kool-Aid every day.
Wow. And you've done now, you've done TV, movies, yes. You've done theater.
I've done everything.
Reality.
Thing.
So having a taste of that TV buzz and being on the camera, is your first love? Are you still, the radio is where your heart is? Or are you know, like, are you ready to cross on over?
I wanted to do news, Kim.
Ah!
And until it was in front of me and it was like, Sasha, you know, you have to read the monitor. You can't give your opinions. Oh. And I was like, what? I can't do that. Okay, like, wait a minute, that's not for me.
Oh,
and
no.
I eased my way into radio.
Wow.
Because I wanted to do both. Mm-hmm. And radio, yes, God, radio is my love, the listeners. I love television, too. But, God, when a listener walks up to you and they can tell you verbatim what you have said or how you have touched their lives or the mm-hmm. song that you played. Can I take a picture with you?
Yes.
Can I get your autograph? I mean, I love it and I thank God for that.
See, that passion, it's in you. That's the passion within. And see, and it comes through your voice.
Yeah.
They can feel it through the radio, even though they're not sitting right there in front of you or you're not on the camera, but you're in their car, you're in their home, you're in their businesses, the shops. They like,
we go to church together. Yes. We go to the same grocery stores together. Our kids do the same thing. Mm-hmm. We experience the same thing, but it just means a lot when they run up to you like that. You're like, wow, thank you.
Well, look, I'm gonna give you a little quick little buzz here.
I came here
because I'm in event planning and meeting planning arena and doing marketing. And I was here in 2003.
Okay.
For the NBA All-Star Weekend, my client was Dada Footwear.
Okay.
And we had Chris Webber was our guy, and we did it at this place called The Clubhouse, which is gone. It was a restaurant at Lenox or something. And I was coming to town, and we had some promo stuff to do, and we had to come by the radio station.
Okay.
And I'm telling you right now, your then is not your now.
Nope.
Girl, I said, that's
like, yep, the blonde hair.
Yes!
140 pounds.
Yes, you.
Thicker.
Yeah, you. I was like, that's, girl,
I
your then
thick-ums.
Is not your now.
Nope. But Kim, back then, I'm still the same person.
Yes.
I made the same attitude.
Wow.
Thought I was sexy.
Yes, always.
All of that. But had to make some changes, major health issues.
Ah, look at that.
And when you have those kind of problems, you have to make a decision. The decision is, does food taste that good that I want to be 6 feet under?
No.
Oh, does food taste that good that you're going to have strokes?
Mm-mm.
It just doesn't taste that good.
Wow.
So I had to make some changes because of major health issues.
So you can talk to a lot of people.
They'll be looking at me and they'll be like, what's she talking about? She lost weight. She don't know about no weight. I'll be like, boo. I was 24. Now, I was fine and fabulous and everything, but I was 24. What you talking about?
Yes.
Girl would eat scrapple and scrambled eggs and toast and grits and chocolate milk in the morning and a sub and cheese and the French fries
and all
a big
that in
soda
the afternoon.
And then dinner time.
Here we go
soul
again.
Food.
Ooh,
that was my
green.
Day.
Okay, all that good, and that was every day.
Now.
Oh no, now.
I
oh,
don't
yeah.
know.
Now, yeah, I'm
now
telling
I do
you,
it.
I'm telling you.
I do it.
But in moderation.
And little plate.
See?
Once a month.
Yes, that's
oh,
good.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And this, Kim, do you know I think about my weight every day?
Wow.
Still. Well,
oh, this is just so much. Oh, this is good.
Every
this
day.
It's just good.
Every day. I get
good
on the
food
scale.
For the soul when
every
you're
day.
Talking. Uh-huh.
Every day.
Wow.
No
well, look,
clothes, I gotta
we gotta take a quick break. We're gonna be back. This is awesome. We can just go.
We vibing.
Yes, yes. We'll be right back. Are back and I'm telling you, we've been chopping it up. We've been having a great time
right.
here. My goodness, it's good. But now you're not just an actress, a radio personality, a fitness guru, maybe I should say.
Right.
I don't know.
Right.
And what you do, but now you are an author. You have this great book, Blended But Not Broken.
Yeah, Kim, it was hard.
This is awesome.
It was tough. it was really tough going through that whole experience with my son and my husband. I'm telling you, so many people don't think about it. They fall in love. And they don't think about the union of the spouse and the child and what it does to a child.
Oh, yes.
And what it did to my family. It just messed me up.
Now, with your siblings, are you guys blended as well, or you guys...
No, babe, I had my mother and my father, and they had their two children, and my parents were married for 46 years before my dad passed away. So that's all I knew.
Right, right. And see, I come from the blended side. I'm my dad's only child. But my dad married my mother with four children.
Wow.
And I call him, a lot of people say, that's your step. I'm like,
no,
like,
we're brother and sister.
That's my brother and sister. So, you know, we may not have the same dad, but that's my brother. And those are my sisters. And, you know, so you know, this
you
speaks
understood.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Do you know,
yes,
for a long time, I would not date people with children? I was like, I don't want to do that.
Wow.
And then I did. And I was like, how many kids you have?
That's the question of the day.
Okay, how many? Okay, two. Okay, fine. I'll deal with that.
Well, I don't want no babies. Anyway, they need to be in high school on their way to college.
Girl, I mean, at this age now, this is not a good thing.
No.
But just for us, my son having me by himself, our lifestyle.
Oh, wow.
And then you bring a husband. And Kim, it's always this question when you're dating. When do you introduce your child
to the person?
That is so hard.
It is hard because it is because sometimes you may do it too soon,
yes,
and then sometimes you wait too long and then come to, it's like.
I did it both ways.
Oh.
In both ways, it was wrong.
Wow.
And then Iyanla had to check me because she felt like I didn't do what was necessary to make sure they was okay. And I didn't see that because I was so in love and he was treating me so great. So I assumed everything would work all together.
So, I mean, you can speak to so many people, so many families. Is this a platform that you do now that you're going out and speaking to? Maybe people that are in children, families, you know, like that are having family issues or they're going to
Can
therapy.
I tell you, it took a minute because even after the show, it don't fix like that.
Oh, we
still had to do counseling. And finally, once I was at a peaceful place and my husband and son were actually talking and communicating, I was like, my husband said, we need to do this. And we just did it.
Sat down and did it.
And just telling the truth.
Oh, being so transparent. Yes.
Let me tell you, it's just real.
Yes. And people need to see the realness. They need to know it needs to come out. Because again,
there's
so many people that are dealing with that, you know, and with so many single moms and then people getting to a certain point. I mean, how long do you know, everybody, I don't want to grow all by myself. I want somebody on the porch rocking with me.
But you know what the responsibility we have?
Mm-hmm.
That when we have kids, they don't ask to be here.
Right.
So because they don't, our obligation is to them.
Well, my babies are grown now.
Right, but see, you're in a different situation.
But
at the end of the day,
if I
had to do it over again, what I experienced, I would have never.
Yes, and I mean, you know, at a point in my life, you know, I was a single parent, you know, and I actually relocated with my children. You know, my ex-husband is still up in New Jersey, still there. Yes, he is.
Hey.
But anyway, I relocated and went to Florida before coming here with my children, so I experienced that. And yes, but you know, I was so focused on building my business and my brand that that was my focus. But then there came a time where I was like, okay, they're getting older. I'm doing this.
Me.
I'm sacrificing.
Now what about me?
Now where does my quality, quiet time, where's the time for that? So, you know, you're right. It's a balance. You got to work it out, but it is what it is. And this is good for people to be able to see that and see themselves through what you have and what you're doing.
And ask the questions
and be honest
to yourself, because at the end of the day, what's going to end up happening, it's going to be explosive.
Right.
And it's going to hurt your kids. You're going to be devastated.
Oh,
he's going to want to leave. And you have
everything.
You got another broken family.
Right. And we don't want that.
Yeah.
We don't want that.
My family, honey.
Yes. Congratulations. This is good.
Yeah,
that's great, and it shows, and I am so
proud
of you.
My son calls my husband. He's in school, and he calls him first.
Oh, that's nice.
When things are going on, and then
that's good.
And just through general conversation, my husband be like, "Oh yeah, I knew that," and I'd be like,
Yeah, but what? that's good. He needed to do, and that bond is there, and he needs to talk to him, you know, as a guy, because my boys had to call their uncle, my brother, which was so they, had, you know, give him the best advice you think you got.
Right.
Well,
right.
Look, I want to just thank you for coming and hanging out with me today. This was great, I'm gonna hang out with you. I'm gonna have to come and to something, some of the events, and I mean, you do so many. I mean, you're in the car industry,
everywhere,
you're doing healthcare, hair care, all that good stuff. But I will see you at the Black Women Expo, so that's good. All right.
Love you, Kim.
Oh, love you too. Well, look, guys, look, I'm gonna take a break. We'll be right back.
At Just For You Women's Healthcare, everything we do is just for you. We offer a range of well women care, from your annual exams to weight loss, vitamins, and natural supplements. We're with you throughout life. From obstetrics and pregnancy care to menopausal care and even laparoscopic surgery, should you need it. Take the first step. Call us and schedule an appointment today. We look forward to caring just for you.
Pain and confusion are common following an accident, especially when you experience severe pain and mounting medical bills. You need the best. Call Price Boyd Law Firm. Attorney Andrea Boyd is ready to listen and help you get the compensation you deserve. She offers free consultations, so call now.
Hi, I'm Andrea Boyd.
And I'm Attorney Charles Singleton of the Price Boyd Law Firm.
If you need a lawyer, call us. We're ready to represent you.
We aggressively advocate for our clients with passion, purpose, and promise.
Well, my next guest is amazing. He is just re-entering into the entertainment industry. He is so unique at what he does. I want you all to welcome Mr. Garfield Collins. How are you?
I am excellent. You?
Oh, I love that voice. Okay.
You know.
That's you, huh?
It's just me.
Okay. Well, look, I'm glad you could come and sit down with me today. You know, we don't have a lot of guys on the show, but I like to show a little diversity.
It is my pleasure.
Oh,
thank you for inviting me.
But look, now you've been in the public relations, sales, marketing arena. You've worked with some of the best in the industry, Celine Dion, Rihanna, the bad boy Chris Brown. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about that journey.
You see, when these artists, when they do shows and they travel and so on, it's a whole production.
Wow.
So there's a lot going behind the scenes. Months of planning, months of arranging flights, hotels, hosting, even that simple little thing like getting a limousine is a big production and so
yes,
on. So
I can
I'm
imagine.
The person who was behind the scenes making sure that those things were happening. From the minute they arrived at the airport to the minute they arrived at their hotel, whether it be in Jamaica or Bahamas or wherever it is that we're hosting them, I was that guy.
Of course,
with my background in the hotel industry,
yes, that's right, because that's what you have your master's degree in, right?
Hotel management.
Look at that. So you know, I heard there was a hotel being auctioned off in Atlanta, the Hilton. And Perimeter, you gonna get in on that?
Well, I need like about $1 billion to actually win that.
Okay, so, you look like a man. What? It's just reaching the back pocket.
Well, looking like the billion and actually having the billion is a whole
different
scenario.
Thing, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my goodness. Yes. Oh my goodness. Well, you are a native of Jamaica?
Yes, I'm Jamaican. Living here in Atlanta. And you know, ever since I came to Atlanta in 2000 on a business trip, I just fell in love with the city.
Wow.
And when I moved to the U.S. full-time in 2009, I actually moved to New York, where you're originally from.
Yes, yes.
And then I said, okay, you know what? New York was okay for a couple of years. Then we're in Atlanta now, and Atlanta is home.
Wow, that is great. That is great.
I'm happy to be here. It just feels like a perfect fit.
Well, you have done so much. I mean, you've been the master of ceremonies for the New York Fashion Week, which is a big, big event.
We did Fashion Week,
That's a big to-do.
Because, you see, I know a few designers. So, you know, there are different shows that we get into and so on, and different hosting events and so on.
Uh-huh.
I mean, even here in Atlanta, I have even presented at the annual Gospel Awards.
Yes.
And that just went a couple of days ago. They had the 2015 edition of that. I also host a lot of events across the U.S. because with my current position, I cover 50% of the U.S. in terms of states. So I'm always on the road. I'm hardly ever in Atlanta. Well, you have to be, and trust me, with my background in travel, I can be anywhere on any given day, any given city.
Any given time.
Yes. And it's funny, you know, some people say that they wake up sometimes and they forget where they are because they travel so much. I've experienced it.
Wow.
I've woken up and said, like, okay, where the heck am I today? Because sometimes you're on the road for a whole week.
Yeah.
And it's flight after flight after flight. And you literally wake up in a hotel room and you're like, okay, I know I'm doing an event today. And you literally forgot what city you were in.
Oh, my goodness.
And you have to look at your book and say, okay, I'm in Dallas. Let's do this.
I'm in Dallas. You know? So with what you do, because you're in the hotel or the hospitality industry.
Right.
What are some of the challenges that you run into in that industry? Because, you know, we have a lot. I mean, we have the international airport here. We have a lot that's going on with hospitality throughout Atlanta and a lot of different areas. What is something that, you know, that you see as challenging that you've overcome in all of that?
All right. I am in charge of the sales and marketing for Breezes Resorts and Room Resorts.
Okay.
Breezes in the Bahamas, Breezes in Cuba, and Rooms on the Beach in Jamaica, in Negroland, and Ocho Rios. I am the person where you as a traveler might not know me, but your travel agent would.
Ah.
I am the, like, you call your travel agent and say, I want to go somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Your travel agent and I would then talk and say, okay, we're going to try to get this client to Breezes and so on.
Mm-hmm.
We know what the rates are. We know what category room is going to be done and so on. So let's get this done. And then I'm the person who would get that done behind the scenes. The challenge is that there are a million hotels in the world.
Mm.
So my job is to get travel agents to book my hotel.
Ah, look at you.
You see, a lot of people think that you build a hotel and it just automatically fills itself up. No. The marketing that has to go behind. The minute a hotel is conceptualized, what it's going to be, where it's going to be located, everything, marketing starts. The sales and marketing team gets on the road, and you're literally meeting with travel agents and travel companies every day.
Every day.
And your phone, your email, everything.
Everything.
And travel agents are throughout the U.S., throughout Canada, throughout the whole world.
Uh-huh.
They have to know your face.
Mm.
Because why are they going to book? Right. It's about
relationships.
It's the relationship that sells the resort.
Wow.
Or with any product, really.
Uh-huh.
I mean, he or she could sell any hotel they want to.
Good.
What makes them sell yours?
Well, look, you have over 10 gold medal awards. Now, is this something that's Olympic? Hussein Bolt, what's going on here?
Well, I wish I was Hussein. You know, trust me. I am a connoisseur of the culinary world.
Okay.
When it comes to cooking, wines, cheeses, that kind of thing, I like that.
Okay.
So whenever time there are culinary events or competitions and so on, you'll find that I will enter and I most times always walk away with a medal or two. Yes. I mean, not to say I'm really, really good, but I'm okay. I can handle myself.
That's good.
I can handle a knife in the kitchen.
Well,
trust
Laura,
me.
Let me give you a hand. That is great. Now, you are a single dad. You're a single parent. You're
I am a single dad with a 13-year-old who thinks she's 20. So.
Oh, boy, that's challenging.
Yes.
But that's impressive. That's good. Because people need to know, God, you know, they always look at us as being, you know, women. Single parents, but the guys are doing
it. It is a challenge.
Yes.
It's a challenge, but I can tell you it's something that I wouldn't change a thing about.
You wouldn't
give it a pleasure just raising her, watch the person that she's becoming and so on.
Her personality.
And watch her personality evolve. Because she'll be this person today, and tomorrow morning she'll be like, I'm like, okay. So, yeah, but I just give her room to blossom.
That's it. That is great. Yes. That is so good. Well, you've done a lot of interviews throughout, the U.S., and you're global. Like you said, you travel all over the world and do so many things. And, I mean, it's great that you have all that versatility and you have those experiences because I'm quite sure it comes through in everything that you do.
Well, put it, it has become automatic for me. Like, the marketing side of me is that I walk into a room and it's like, something switches on. I can't explain it,
but
I'm not shy. put it that way.
Okay.
I can be in any room with any group of people and just fit right in. And it's something people say, how do you do that? I'm like, I don't know. It's natural. It just comes to me.
It's just a natural thing.
I am not shy. I'm not timid. I'm not, you know, intimidated. I'm just...
Just who you are.
You walk into a room and people know you're there. You own that room. And I can tell you, that's my aim here in Atlanta.
Okay, that's good.
Yes.
That's good. So we got to walk in the room together. Because I know we hung out in Oklahoma City together.
Yes, we did Oklahoma City together for the Miss MD USA.
I want to say thank you for coming to the Women on the Move Summit and hanging out with us.
It was my pleasure. I'm happy that I actually drove out tomorrow to your event. It was an excellent event.
Good.
And your guests and so, they were excellent.
Good.
Yeah, they showed me love. Some good
stamp of approval over here. This gold medalist, too. All right.
All right, this man with all this knowledge in the industry. You so know. Thank you so much. But look, I'm looking forward to what's to come. I mean, I know we're going to be doing some things before the year is out.
Yes.
So I'm looking forward to that.
Well, you can say it.
Oh, I can say it.
We're going to Cuba.
We're going to Cuba!
Yes, we're taking already. A few select friends from Atlanta and New York and so on. We're flying down to Havana and Varadero.
Yes,
and
I
of course,
wait.
We're going to be staying at Breezy's Varadero.
Yeah.
And we're going to enjoy the resort and see what it's about. And we're also going to spend a couple days in Havana so we can come back and
I'm
spread
excited.
The word about it.
Yes,
and so
I'm excited. I can't wait.
It's going
wait.
To be an awesome trip.
It is. That's my Christmas present.
Yeah.
Well, look, Garfield, I thank you so much for hanging out with me today and being able to just come by and sit on the couch and just share a little bit of who you are and what you do with those that tune in to Women on the Move Live. And,
yes.
and it's just been a pleasure.
It has been my pleasure, and thank you for having me.
All right. Well, we're going to take a break, and we'll be right back.
There is a place where total health care for women is a reality. Women's Health Institute is a one-stop total health boutique dedicated exclusively to women. Whether you are looking to alleviate pain or eliminate your varicose veins, we provide patients with state-of-the-art medical facilities in a spa-like environment. Dr. Umera, Dr. Francis, and Dr. Edmonds have the knowledge and preparation for the essential understanding of your pregnancy. Every birth is a special event, and we make every effort to keep our patients informed. Women's Health of Georgia.
Hey, listen, I want to thank everybody, my panelists, all my special guests, and all the women and men that came out to the third annual Women on the Move Summit. It was a great event, and I'm truly, truly humbled and thankful that you guys came out. But look, I want to show some clips from today. Check this out.
Engagement is coming up. What do you have to say? This pop right back into my
loves an experience.
So many inspiring women. I feel so blessed to be here.
It is inspirational, inspiring. It reminds me of what I need to do.
Listen, today's show was amazing. I want to thank Heritage Cadillac of Morrow for sponsoring this great show, Women on the Move Live. I want to thank Sasha the Diva for sitting down with us today, coming off the radio and coming on TV. And again, Mr. Garfield Collins for just sitting in as well. I just want to thank everybody, and I thank you for tuning in each and every week. So, you know what? I'm going to sign off, and I'll see you next week.